Welcome to the Atlas Detector at CERN. Well, that's just a painting of it. The real one is deep underground. It's one of the two main experiments here at the LHC that's looking for all sorts of new physics. In 2012, it found the Higgs boson in a theory that was so elegant and beautiful. But the real way that particle physics works is it's not as easy as just looking at a Feynman diagram, looking at an event in a display and saying, there we go, we found it. In fact, particle physicists, what they really do is play an elaborate game of dice. To explain what I mean by that, let's forget that we're at CERN and instead pretend that we're at a casino. A casino run by a rather unscrupulous owner. Now, there is a hypothesis that this casino owner is introducing unfair dice. But can we work out if there are unfair dice within the casino? By counting the number of times that a certain result comes up on the dice, we can work out the likelihood that the dice were fair or otherwise. Now, obviously, if this were a fair dice, you'd expect the probability of any given number to turn up would be 1/6. Roll the dice 60 times, you'd expect 10 of each number, and 600 times, and then that's 100. But of course, that's only the average of what you get. So how far away from that average do you have to go for us to start to get a bit worried? It's actually quite easy to work out the probability. We can draw up the distribution. As you can see, for 60 rolls, the distribution peaks at 10, but it has some width to it. So for instance, we shouldn't be too worried if we got 20 sixes out instead of just 10 as expected. But as we up the number of rolls, the distribution gets a lot slimmer. We can use the width of those distributions as measured in standard deviations as a sort of measure of the likelihood of getting this result out purely by chance. Particle physicists often take 5 sigma to be the benchmark for a discovery. That's a probability of 1 in 1,744,278 of being purely down to chance. So to find out if there are any unfair dice within this pile, we need to roll all of these dice a lot and then work out the chance of this being different from what's fair.
6, 4.
By rolling the dice lots of times, we can experimentally measure the probabilities associated with each number on the die. That's what you can see in the top panel in blue. And we compare that with what's expected for a fair dice, a value of a 6th. Where we also showed the 1 and 3 sigma levels around that as the coloured bands. So for evidence of loaded dice, we're looking for a bump that pops above the green. Or more precisely, we look for the significance of any differences between the data and what's expected for fair dice. That's what's shown in the bottom panel, as measured in sigma. We do a fairly straightforward comparison in the blue, known as the local significance. But remember, we've got 6 different numbers to play with. So actually, the global significance is a little bit less. And that's what's given in red. But as you can see, this is pretty slow going. So you know what? I'm going to employ a little bit of help. As we pull all the data together, we see a lot of fluctuations, some potential results appearing and then disappearing. But finally, we can see that there are some dice weighted to the number 6. Only a 10th of them were unfair. So what has all this dice throwing got to do with particle physics? Well, you can think of the weighted dice as being the signal, the thing that we're actually looking for, and all of the ordinary dice being a background. This is exactly what particle physicists do when they're looking for a new particle. If they have an idea of how it can decay into known particles, they can look for that channel. That's the signal that they're after. But of course, there's lots of different ways that you can produce those same particles. So you have a background going on as well, processes that you're not particularly interested in. It's separating out the signal from the background that is the key thing to do if you want to prove there's a new particle. Right through that glass is the Atlas Control Center. That is where it all happens. They can see all of the 40 million collisions that are happening every second, but they can't tell what each collision is. It's only by processing it with the statistics that you can actually tell whether you've detected a particle. So while Einstein famously said, "God doesn't play dice," it's for definite that particle physicists do. Thank you so much for joining me at the Atlas Detector for this video. If you did like it, please do give it a thumbs up. You can subscribe for more physics as well, and I'll see you soon.